We'll continue with our functions. Have a question. In a given table, okay, in the student details table, in the student details table, if Manu is present, if a student called Manu is present, find out his student ID. If Manu is present, find out Manu's student ID. Hope the question is very clear. In a given table, if a particular record is there, get another column field of that particular record. Okay, so we'll start writing the function directly. Create or replace. Okay, I'll write this so that you know, in case my function goes wrong and I retype, it gets saved in the same name. Okay, Manuchik. Okay, I'm just writing a function to check whether or name check. I'll be general. Okay, name check.
Note afternoon class in the
So I'm having a function called name check. There will be a return. I'm not sure about what will be the return. So, you know, I'll have some return. Just keep some dashes over there. If something, yeah. And then I'll write my, start my function. I'll have a function. I'll have my code. I'll finish off my function. Yeah. So that's my function. And then even have my main. I might have some declare. I'm not sure. Okay, I might have some declare, but anyway, you know, I'll have a begin, I'll have an end. Okay, and then I'll finish it off. Okay, so I've just created the structure. Now I'll do the remaining. Okay, now my question is, I'll have to check whether a particular name is there, and if that particular name is there, I will have to return the. I'll have to check whether Manu is there. And if Manu is there, I will have to return his ID. So before that, let me just check what are my data types. Disk, student details. Okay, so I have name, which is a varchar 2, size 10, and SID also I do have varchar. So, you know, I'm planning to return my SID because, you know, I need to find out my name. So, you know, I'm very sure my return is nothing but a varchar 2. Okay. And I even need to store it into a variable. So, you know, I'll just give SID. In my table, it is S underscore ID. I'll just make it SID here, simple. And then I'll have varchar 2. What was the size over there? The size over there was 5. Okay, so I'll go with the same size. Varchar 2, 5. Okay, so I'm returning varchar 2. And then the variable I am planning to return is my SID. So, you know, here I will be returning what? Name check the variable, and of course it is a varchar. Okay, so I'll have a variable over here to take in that. I'll just give something called CID or something, the same size. Because, you know, I need to receive it into a variable which has got almost the same size. Okay, so CID is equal to STC, and then I'll even do a bit of a output. I'll just copy it over there. I'll paste this over here. DBMS check, DBMS outline, output, put line, everything. So what am I planning to display? I'm planning to display my Manu's ID. Okay, so I'll write. The codes need to come correctly. Okay, anyway. Manu's ID is, okay, what is Manu's ID? Manu's ID is CID. Okay, so my structure is okay. I am having a return of varchar 2. Okay, and then I'll be returning it CID name check, and then I am displaying. Now let's come to the code. Okay, you have to find out Manu's ID. So how do you get Manu's ID from here? Very simple. I can write a query: select S underscore ID from STU underscore details, where S underscore name is equal to Manu. Okay, so whenever you write all these cursors, functions, procedures, triggers, and all that, the query which you're planning to write, just run it over there in your SQL plus and see whether your query is correct. Okay, now you know Manu R128. So my query is correct. So what I'll do is I'll just simply copy the same query, because you know that is an exact that is exactly what I want. I'll copy that query, I'll just put it over here. Okay, so this is a perfectly working query. Select SID from student details, where S name is equal to Manu. I will get my student ID. I need to store it into another variable called SID. So I'll simply write over here, store it into my SID. Store it into my SID. And this SID I should be returning. Return what? Return this SID outside of the function. Okay, I return it outside of my function. It comes here, it gets stored into a value called CID. Yeah, so that's it. So let me first check my function for any errors. Just copy it, I'll put it over here. Okay, so there's no problem in my function. Now let's run my main. Okay, so I have an error. I have a problem with my quotes. I'll do one thing. The best thing is, you know, I'll put a quote over here. I'll copy it. I knew I would have problem in my quotes. Okay. I'll copy it. Okay, set server output. I didn't do that. Set server output on. Okay, I'll run it once again. Yeah, I get it. Manu's ID is R128. Okay, now the same way you have done this, let's say you want to find out which city is Manu. As you all know, a function, you can return only one value. Here I've returned SID. Let's go continue writing over here. Imagine you want to find out even Manu's city. Okay, let's find out what is Manu's city. Manu's city is Kannur. Okay, Manu's city is stored in a variable called city. It is Kannur, and city is a varchar 210. Imagine you want to even find out Manu's city. Very simple. I'll just copy the same query over here. I'll put it over here. Select not SID. Select city into not SID. You'll have another variable called city, varchar 2 of 10. I hope it was 10. Okay, into not SID, city. Okay, and then together with this, I'll have two displays. One is for Manu's ID, and the other one is for Manu's city. Manu's city is what? SCT. Okay, so there's no change in my function. So I need not run my function again. I just need to run my main portion again. That is where I've done change. We'll come back here. Okay, yeah, I got it perfect. Manu's ID is 128. Manu's city is Kannur. Okay, you can do all these other displays over here. Like, you know, Manu exists, Manu does not exist, and all that. All that can be done. So this is how you can check whether a particular record exists. And if that record exists, you can be able to pull out other details of that particular record. the same function will do a small variation. Now look here, I did not pass in any variable over here. I did not pass in any variable over here, which means, you know, this, it is empty. I don't have anything over here. Now let's modify the function a bit so that we pass variables. Okay, so I have a small question. Let me check my table first. Okay, so in your student details table, in the student details table, okay, find out the name of the student. Find out the name of the student who takes course ID 55. The name of the student, the name or the ID, anything of the student, or the date of joining, whichever date of the, whose student ID is CID 55. Okay, very simple. I'll pass 55 over here. That's it. I'll just do away with all these unwanted things. Okay, so I'm passing 55, which means I have an in variable over here. I have an in variable. What it is, 55. 55 is nothing but a number. Okay, so I'll write number. I'll just name it. I'll give it a pet name called X, my variable. Okay, I'm returning something. Let all that be the same. What am I planning to return? I'll return the name. So varkar. Okay, name varkar 2, select, I'm not doing the ID, I'm name into name where, from student details, where what CID is equal to 55, where CID is equal to what, which 55? This 55. But this 55, I'm passing it in over here X. So I just need to simply give where CID is equal to X, return name. Okay. So let me just check, name check, create or replace X in number. I'm returning varkar 2, size 5. Okay. Let me just check my name is 10. Okay. So I'll just give this 10 to be on the safer side. Okay. Return name. Okay. So here, I will not need all these, right? CID, I'll just give another name for this, not city, name. This I will not need. You can either comment it or delete it. Name is equal to, okay, and then I can do my output. Just copy my output over here. Control C, Control V. Name of student is what, NM. Okay, so very simple. All what I've done is, instead of doing it like earlier, I am passing in a small variable and then I'm doing the remaining. So I'll just copy this. I'll first check whether there's any problem with my function. Copy. Yeah, the function, there's no problem. Let me even check my main. Okay, name of the student is Rahul, but mind you, I got Rahul because, you know, there was only one guy with 55. But, you know, if I get a number called 58 or 78, your normal query will not work. Multiple rows means you will have to go for a cursor, which we already saw. Okay, so we've revised how to even do it by passing a